I have a history background and I should know better, but here's the deal. I can never remember the difference between longitude and latitude. To me, longitude should be like going long and it should be wide, and latitude should be a ladder and going up. So I think longitude are the lines that go this way and latitude is that way, but actually I'm thinking now I'm wrong. I don't know. See, like already I'm forgetting it. And I think maybe 5 minutes ago I tried to relearn it and I've already forgotten it. And I bring this up because this is actually a common phenomenon that we get two corresponding things confused often through a process called interference. And you see it all the time. I know a lot of adults who don't know the difference between an x-axis and a y-axis. Now, the x-axis is the independent variable. The y-axis is the result of it, the dependent variable. But when you see the equation y equals mx plus b, you often will think then that the y is the driver of it, and sometimes you just get confused, the x and the y and what goes where, right? And you see this all the time. It's why certain people can never remember which one represents yin and which one represents yang. This is a really common phenomenon, and it happens every time that you teach two things that are related to each other, that are often complementary, but in a way that doesn't necessarily make sense in terms of the vocabulary. And you have this interference thing that goes on back and forth where it becomes hard to remember which one is which. And the truth of the matter is, it's easy to get two different things that are related to each other confused. I should know because I'm a twin. And when I say a twin, I mean like I have somebody identical who looks like me. I'm not a baseball player. I wish I was a twin. It'd be awesome to be on the Minnesota Twins. But the bottom line is, I get it. People confuse me all the time with my brother, even as an adult when we've gone out. It happens. The same thing is true with fiction and nonfiction, right? On the surface, fiction could sound like fact and nonfiction would sound like not fact, and therefore you get confused. And as a second grader or a third grader, you're getting lost on which one is which. I know I didn't really truly get the difference between fiction and nonfiction until maybe the fifth or sixth grade. And even then I kept getting it tripped up and I just kept using it until I finally got it. And again, those two ideas are opposite, but they're very easy to get confused. And this happens anytime you have two binaries where the language doesn't necessarily make sense from the get-go. If you compare, for example, synchronous and asynchronous, synchronous sounds like synchronized swimming. We get it, we know it, it's in the moment. Asynchronous is just making it not true, adding an A to it. So of course, asynchronous and synchronous, that's not gonna cause a lot of interference. So what do we do about this as educators? How do we avoid interference? Well, it actually works to teach one concept first and then teach the opposite concept way later. I'll give an example, x-axis and y-axis. I noticed that students really struggled with this when I taught middle school. So when I taught eighth grade math, linear equations, x and y, we would really not get into that anyway until the second quarter, actually end of second quarter, almost third quarter. So the very first week of school, I taught students about the x-axis, and we actually learned it through science, and it was the independent variable. Now they asked, is there anything, you know, related to it? Is there a dependent variable? And I said, yeah, but we won't get into that until way later. And so I did a concept attainment lesson. I taught the vocabulary, and they solidified the idea that the piece that you control in an experiment, in any kind of an equation, is this thing of x. And then we would solve for x, and we practiced that, and they had a real deep conceptual understanding and a good vocabulary understanding of the x-axis so that they can then later on learn about the y-axis, and there was no confusion. I said, remember how you learned the x-axis? We have that down. There's this opposite thing now called the y-axis. It's important because we tend to think, let's teach all of those things together and see how they interact with each other. But what that can do is that can create confusion. So the more we can do this, isolate those two complementary ideas and teach them separately and then put them together in a composite way, the better off we'll be in terms of avoiding interference. So there we have it. This is not something that happens all the time, but if you can think of moments where students are confusing two different terms, just separate those things out early on in the year and later on in the year, focus on understanding the vocabulary and the concept of one first, and then teach the other one later, and you'll find that it's going to work a lot better. Hey, thank you for watching this video. Would you do me a favor? If you enjoy this video, would you click on the like button and consider subscribing to this channel?